And now they put the crack cocaine, in our community, and it demoralized the African workers and poor people who are the heartbeat of the revolution. Let me tell you that. That's where the revolution is. And when they did this to the young African workers and poor people, then we saw all these other so-called Negro leaders who would come up attacking the community. The problem was the community. We need to atone. We need this and that. It wasn't that the government was the problem. It was the people who were the problem. And so we had to struggle against this concept that was out there, even among the African working class itself. Because what we found is that the people who were out pushing crack cocaine often thought it was their idea that they were doing it. They thought, I'm out here doing this because this is my idea, but it wasn't their idea. What the imperialists, the capitalists, what white power had done was take away all the other options and say, if you want to live, this is what you can do to live on, and put crack cocaine there. I'm not a hunter, but I'm told that in places like in the Arctic, where indigenous people sometimes might hunt a wolf, they'll take a double-edged blade and they'll put blood on the blade and they'll melt the ice and stick the handle in the ice so that only the blade is protruding, and that a wolf will smell the blood and wants to eat, and it'll come and lick the blade trying to eat. And what happens is when the wolf licks the blade, of course, he cuts his tongue and he bleeds and he thinks he's really having a good thing. He drinks and he licks, and of course he's drinking his own blood and he kills himself. That's what the imperialists did to us with crack cocaine. You got these young brothers out there thinking that they're getting something that they're going to make a living with. They're getting something they can buy a car like the white people have cars. Why can't I have a car? They're getting something that they can get a piece of gold. The white people have gold. Why can't I have gold? They're getting something to get a house. The white people have a house. Why can't I have a house? And they actually think that it's something that's bringing resources to them, but they're killing themselves just like the wolf who's licking the blade, and they're slowly dying without knowing. That's what's happening to the community. You with me on that? That's exactly and precisely what happens to the community. And instead of blaming the hunter who put the damn handle and the blade in the ice for the wolf, that what happens is the wolf gets blamed for trying to live. That's what happens in our community. You don't blame the person, the victim, you blame the oppressor. Imperialism, white power is the enemy. Was the enemy when it first came to Africa, snatched up the first African, brought us here against our will, is the enemy today. That's the thing that we have to understand. And there can't be any compromise on that. No compromise on it. I know your television got stolen, mine too. But we can't limit the discussion and the issue and the understanding to some immediate personal contradiction that we have with somebody who's victimized by imperialism. I know you got a sister or an aunt or a cousin or somebody who ripped you off because they own that stuff. But we can't limit our understanding based on our own personal relationship to it, because imperialism is making war against all of us. And he got hooked first, and then and he becomes an instrument of imperialism when he does what he does to us in our community. So the community is demoralized. And this is one of the most effective counterinsurgency tools that you can have, where the actual victim actually believes that he is responsible for what's going on. Where the victim, and then the victims become increasingly demoralized by his behavior, because he knows something's wrong with what he's doing.